Hello and welcome. In this video, I'm going to walk you through how to crochet in the magic ring. Now, the magic ring can seem kind of intimidating and it can be a little tricky to get started, but it is totally worth learning how to do it. Okay, to get started, I'm going to take the tail end of my yarn and I'm going to drape it over my hand so it is draped right across the top of my pointer finger. And I'm going to make sure that I have a little bit of length to work with here. Now I'm going to pinch that with my thumb up against my pointer finger. I'm going to take the working end of my yarn, the rest of the length that is attached to the skein, and I'm going to bring it around my hand between my ring finger and my pinky finger. And as I bring that around, I'm going to tuck it between my thumb and my pointer finger. It's kind of hard to see that. Now I need to get that between my pinky and my ring finger. So what I'm pointing at here, that is the working length. That is the longest length, and that is crossed over the top of that shorter one. But the shorter one is the closest to the tips of my fingers. The longest one is the closest to my knuckles. Now I need to get my hook in here. So I'm gonna put my hook in there, catch that strand, pull it forward, give it a twist, and then I'm gonna bring it around and catch that length of yarn that is closest to my knuckles and bring it back around and pull a slip stitch. Now you missed that, but that's all I did was create a slip stitch. Now that I have my ring started, I'm gonna kind of tighten it up a little bit so I can get it on my fingers, and now it's gonna stay fairly snug for the time being so I can get started. Okay, so from here on out, you're basically just gonna follow whatever pattern instructions are written for you. If you're doing a single crochet, you would chain one. Half double crochet is typically two. Double crochet is typically three. It just depends on how the pattern is written for you. I chained two and then immediately went in with a double crochet. But again, it's whatever works for you or however the pattern is written. This is just a sample, so it doesn't really matter. The principle is still the same when you start your magic ring. There's loads of different ways that you can start a magic ring. I prefer this one because I like how easy it is to get that ring tightened up whenever I need to. And you may need to go in occasionally while you're working into it and just kind of snug it up again a little bit so it stays on your fingers. However, at some point when you're going along, you might not have to put it on your fingers anymore. You can just pinch those two strands and continue to work in it. Follow along with however the pattern is written and how many stitches you need to put into this ring. And then when you have your stitches, you're done. You're good to go. It's actually pretty easy once you get the hang of it. Okay, so once you have all of your stitches in the ring, pull on that tail and tighten it up just a little bit, but don't tighten it all the way. You're going to need to slip stitch into that chain space in order to close this. And sometimes if you pull on that too tight right away, it's almost impossible to close up the ring. So give yourself a little bit of wiggle room before you tighten it completely. Once you have that slip stitch in and your ring is closed, now you can finish tightening it up. And this is where the magic happens. You're gonna finish pulling on that tail end until that center gets nice and tight. Make sure you don't pull too hard, otherwise you could potentially break your yarn there. But otherwise, you can give this a pretty decent tug and close that up. And then look at that. There is no hole in the center like a traditional chain and slip stitch to close. So pretty cool. All right, so that is it. If you missed anything, feel free to go back and rewatch. I will also have a link down in the description below for written instructions on the Ruby Grace blog. Thank you so much for stopping by. Love your face.